Michael and Archangel at the NV, and then in Daniel chapter 12, you know, starting at the first verse, you know what I'm saying? He talks about, you know, like the Archangel has, he's going to stand up. Pretty much mean that Michael and Archangel, you know, he's going to have to intervene because then he's going to get bad. Like, you know, but with all that being said, you should not use lose faith. How dark and how deep things may get, you know what I'm saying? You know, no matter how bad things are out here, you should never lose our faith. Yahweh, you know, we go to Hebrews chapter 11, verse 1, it said, not faith is the things hoped for, and the evidence of things not seen. And, you know what I'm saying? We got, in the scripture also tell we got to walk by faith and not by sight. You know what I'm saying? We see there's a lot of wickedness going on. You see what the devil doing, but at the end of the day, man, we have to be focused on Yahweh Shem HaMashiach, and knowing that, you know, all these things going on is not going to take place without the approval of Yahweh Shem HaMashiach. You know what I'm saying? And with all these things come to pass, and you seeing these signs of being foretold, you seeing prophecy come to pass, you know, Luke 21 says to lift up your head, man. Let's just get that. It's Luke chapter 21 and verse 28, and it reads, and when these things begin to come to pass, then look up and lift up your heads, for your redemption draw nigh. And that's a very straight, powerful message if you receive it, man. He said, if you see all these things come to pass, what you are seeing now, you know what I'm saying? The scripture says to lift up your head. Understand to lift up your head because your redemption draw now means that your house shot is pretty much here, man. You know what I'm saying? When we know that we have free prophecies that have to take place, but guess what? Our redemption, which is your house shot and the angels, they on their way back. You know what I'm saying? And you see a chariot activity even going on in the earth. Yeah. Chariot sites popping up in particular places around the world. You even have chariot sites popping up here in Babylon the Great. You know what I'm saying? Which have to force these devils to admit that these things are real, man. You know what I'm saying? It's no denial of that. And these chariots are the salvation of the house of Israel, but particularly the elect. Saying your house shall come back with the host of heaven, which are the angels. He's going to gather up the elect of the house of Israel out of the four corners of the globe. You know, you can also get that in Matthew chapter 24, Mark chapter 13, and Luke chapter 21. You know what I'm saying? They all tells you that the Savior is coming back. You know what I'm saying? Point blank period. He's coming back. He's going to come back with the host of heaven, which are the angels. You know what I'm saying? And guess what? When all these things come to pass, man, you know, scripture tells us to lift up our heads, to look up. You know what I'm saying? You know, as scripture said, we supposed to be watching as well as praying anyway. You know what I'm saying? But look up, because we know that Yahushua coming back, because the scripture says that he's coming back. And Yahweh himself value his word over his name. So whatever the scripture say, you know, you can bank on the day it comes to pass. You know, Yahweh himself put his word above your name. You know that it's very serious. You know what I'm saying? He put his word above his name. So for you brothers and sisters out there who believe in Yahweh Shem HaShah, who are repenting, who come back to the ways of the Most High, Yahweh Shem HaShah, you know what I'm saying? Look up. You know what I'm saying? Because your redemption draw not. You know what I'm saying? You see the chariot sights. You see the chariots patrolling back and forth on the earth. You know what I'm saying? You see particular events that are taking place on the earth. You know, look up. You know what I'm saying? And lift up your head. You know, it's very important to lift up your head. And yeah, we know that this place, you know, with all the wickedness going on on this earth, man, it causes you sometimes to put your head down and to, you know, we be vets, you know. know, be angry, be bitter, and so forth. But, you know what I'm saying, we have to live from our head. We have to understand the fact of the matter that these things have to come to pass. You know, these things have to take place, man. You know what I'm saying, before the kingdom can be established. Because when we get in the kingdom, we will appreciate, you know what I'm saying, righteousness and in fullness thereof, man. We will understand, you know, those who are judges, you know, part of 144,000 will understand how not to rule the world, man. How not to govern the world, you know what I'm saying? Because this wicked rulership is going to be that example on how you not govern the world, man. You know what I'm saying? How you not run the earth, you know what I'm saying? But, you know, men of the Lord, you know, which is 144,000, which are the governing bodies, are going to rule in righteousness, man. And they're going to get it right. You know what I'm saying? And those and the rest of the Israelites, you know, which are the elect, you know what I'm saying? But the elect is going to be on 144,000. The hero of the Israelites is going to be happy that we're back in rulership. You know what I'm saying? We're back on top in our rulership. Kingdom of heaven is going to be a forever rulership. You know what I'm saying? So lift up your head, man. The brothers and sisters out there, lift up your head. So we understand that your house is pretty much on its way back. You know what I'm saying? And it's the scripture. So he's going to come back for a church, which are the Israelites, particularly the elect. He's going to come back for a church without a spot or a wrinkle, man. Meaning that, you know, we got to make sure we have our affairs in order, because the last thing that you want is for your affairs not to be in order. You know what I'm saying? When your house shot comes back. Because if your affairs are not in order, you know what I'm saying, don't expect to get on the chariot, man. You know what I'm saying? Have your affairs in order. You know, lift up your head. Have faith in Yahweh Hashem Al-Shah. You know, believe his word, you know. Yahweh himself bear his word over his name. You know what I'm saying? So believe that Yahweh Shah is gonna come back. Lift up your head, you know what I'm saying? Every day is a day that we're getting closer to the kingdom of heaven, to the throne of David. You know what I'm saying? You think about it that way. Because every day it's a day closer that Yahweh Shah is gonna come back. You know what I'm saying? Every day is a day closer. We're going to get those new spiritual bodies. You know what I'm saying? We're going to be in our perfected state. You know what I'm saying? And the thing about it, this earth is going to be back in the paradise, man. It's going to be refreshed. We'll step closer to that. You know what I'm saying? As the scripture says, Luke 21:28, it says to lift up your head. You know, because your house shot is coming back. You know, our redeemer, you know what I'm saying, our redemption, it draws not. You know, your house shall is way back. And he wants us to save the Israelites, particularly the elect. You know what I'm saying? He wants to take down these heathen nations. You know what I'm saying? That have ruled over us in oppression. That didn't want to tell us who we are. You know what I'm saying? That benefited off of us. You know, they're gonna fall, man. They're gonna be downtrodden. You know what I'm saying? And they're the ones that are gonna be put in slavery in the kingdom of heaven, man. But you know, the Israelites are gonna rule forever and ever and ever and ever, you know what I'm saying? A continual rulership with no end in sight. You know, so lift up your head, man. We're getting closer and closer to that time period, man. And I pray that your brothers and sisters out there be edified with this lesson. You know, with that, I want to give all praise, glory, and honor to one to Yahweh, Hashem, Yahushua, Hashem, Kaka, Gosh, love and honor to the apostles, the elders, and the great millstone. And I respect to the brothers,